to say when I look in your eyes. Noel, Noel, Jesus, our Emmanuel, you're here, and I'm holding you so near. I'm staring into the face of my Savior, King and Creator. You could have left us on our own. I don't know how long I'm gonna have you for, but I'll be watching you when you change the world. Look at your hands, they're still so small. Someday you're gonna stretch them out and save us all. Noel, Noel, God with us, Emmanuel, you're here, and I'm holding you so near. I'm staring into the face. Someday I'm gonna look back on this night that God became my baby boy. Someday you're gonna go home again, but you'll leave your spirit and flood the world with joy. You'll be here, and I'm holding.
Good evening, everybody.
Merry Christmas.
I want to welcome you all as we join together for our Christmas Eve service here out in Barron Park as Crossroads Memorial United Methodist Church and whoever else shows up, because we are happy to celebrate our Savior, our King and Creator, come as a baby boy. And so as we gather tonight, I want you to set aside for a bit all of the hurry and worry of this season, all of the hurry and worry of this year, and fix your eyes on Jesus. There are lots of other things we could turn our attentions to. There's travel, gifts to wrap, family to see, family to argue with over the recent election. and all sorts of other things that could occupy our attention. But tonight, we fix our eyes on the Savior, Jesus, who broke into our world and set us free from the bonds of sin and death itself. Amen? If you will join me as we begin in prayer. Almighty God, King and Creator, Lord and Savior, you are here. And as we come into your presence this evening, we invite you into the midst of ours. Come and meet us here in this place. Come and dwell in us, Emmanuel. Come and make yourself known to us this evening, that we would experience not just generic joy and peace of a holiday season, but the intimacy of your presence with us, the joy that only you can bring, the hope that only comes from salvation, and the peace that passes all understanding in our world. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. This time the Williams family will light our Advent wreath.
While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no guest room available for them. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night.
And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord." Luke 2:6-11.
Let us pray.
We have been waiting for this day. Jesus Christ, Son of God, on this Christmas day, we pray that you would help us live as those who let hope, peace, joy, and love reign in our lives, our families, our home, and our world. As the candles burns brightly and light our home, let us live as those who have the Christ light burning inside of us today and every day. Amen.
Due to the unusual circumstances of our arrangement tonight, we're not going to be passing plates to collect up an offering. But traditionally at our church, Christmas Eve is our opportunity to help collect for the United Methodist Children's Home up in Enterprise, Florida. This is a ministry that we've supported year after year, and normally we have met our obligations by this point. I believe we're still a little bit behind. So here's what I would like you to do. I'd like you to prayerfully consider what the Lord would have you to give. And you can send a check to the church. You can go online on our webpage, carlsonumc.org. You can download our Carlson app, and there are giving options in both of those two places. Or come on Sunday morning and bring a check with you there. Mark it, write it to Carlson Methodist, but on the memo line, put Children's Home. And just prayerfully consider that. It's an amazing ministry. I have known people who have come through that children's home. I have seen from little ones up through ones who came through years and years and years ago and have seen the amazing impact it has on their lives. So please prayerfully consider a gift towards that. Will you pray with me now? Almighty God, we commit ourselves to you in this night and in this time. Lord, use the gifts that we give to you and let them be to your glory. And now, Father God, inhabit the praises of your people. Speak to us as we open your word. Meet us as we sing songs of worship to you. And open our hearts to receive you again this year. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our first scripture reading comes from Isaiah chapter 9, verses 2 and 6 through 7. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land, deep darkness, a light has dawned. You have enlarged the nation and increased their joy. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders. And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the greatness of his government and peace there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness. From that time on and forever, the zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this.
Once again, I want to thank you guys for coming out to our Christmas Eve service here at Carlson. If you would all stand with us as we're going to sing some very traditional Christmas songs. So some of you I see have pamphlets in your hands and they have the words on them. If you don't and you're a little bit more tech savvy, on our Facebook page, if you open up your Facebook app and go to Carlson Memorial United Methodist Church, we have all of the words on the latest post. All of the words of the songs we're going to be singing tonight are on there. So if you want to do that, if you don't have one of those sheets. But like I said, we're going to be singing songs that I think all of you know. I know that before we even started singing any of them, I was like, oh yeah, I know all the words to these. I probably don't even need words. But here we are. I still have the words because I will forget them. But if you guys would just sing along with us. And the order of the songs on the pamphlet, they're a little bit out of order. Just follow along with us and you guys will enjoy it. So let's sing together to Jesus Christ.
Joyful and triumphant, O come ye. Isaiah 11, 1 through 9. Out of the stumps of David's family will grow a shoot, yes, a new branch bearing fruit from the old root. And the Spirit of the Lord will rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. He will delight in obeying the Lord. He will not judge by appearance, not make a decision based on hearsay. He'll give justice to the poor and make the decisions for the exploited. The earth will shake at the force of his word, and one breath from his mouth will destroy the wicked. He will wear righteousness like a belt and truth like an undergarment. In that day, the wolf and the lamb will live together. The leopard will lie down with the baby goat. The calf and the yearling will be safe with the lion. And a little child will lead them all. The cow will graze near the bear. The cub and the calf will lie down together. The lion will eat hay like a cow. The baby will play safely near the hole of a cobra. Yes, a little child will put his hand in the nest of deadly snakes without harm. Nothing will hurt or destroy in all my holy mountain, for as the waters fill the sea, so the earth will be filled with people who know the Lord.
Chapter, the birth of Jesus foretold. In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph.
Okay.
A descendant of David, the virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found your favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end. How will this be, Mary asked the angel, since I am a virgin? The angel answered, the Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age, and she, who was said to be unable to conceive, is in her sixth month. For no word from God will ever fail. I am the Lord's servant, Mary answered. May your word to me be fulfilled. Then the angel left her.
Same region, there were shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone upon them, and they were filled with great fear. And the angel said to them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel the multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those with those whom he is pleased."
Dear Savior's birth.
yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees, oh, hear the angel voices, oh, night divine, oh, night, when Christ was born.
My mic keeps going out. He told me to use his. I just need to grow a foot. The final reading this evening is going to be from Luke 2. It's going to be verses 15 through 19. When the angels had left them and returned to heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go straight to Bethlehem and see what has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." They hurried off and found both Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in the manger. After seeing them, they reported the message they were told about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary was treasuring up all these things in her heart and meditating on them.
You may be seated. Will you pray with me? Almighty God, as we come before you this evening, speak to us. You know the word you want to bring to us this evening. Whatever it is, whatever we need to hear, you know. So speak to us this evening. Send your Holy Spirit deep inside of us to meet us where we need to hear you the most. Tune our minds, our ears, and our hearts to know your voice and to tell it apart from all others. Speak to us, God. Use whatever words I may offer, but you speak to us that we may know and do your will and yours alone. Through Christ our Lord, we pray. Amen. You know, typically it's a little brighter where we do this. We usually have a pretty decent lighting. We can see really well. We don't have to use our phones to read our lyric sheets. Tonight it's a little darker. We're out here because of challenges of this year, uncertainties. And we found ourselves out in the dark. A lot of this year, we felt in the dark. Trying to figure out what's going on with a virus, with social unrest, with an election. Often left with more questions than answers. But I'm here tonight not to tell you about the dark, but to tell you about the light. You know, we have this wreath over here with these candles on it, and if you're used to more traditional congregations, you see we light this thing every year, and every week we add another light to it. We start out lighting just one candle the first week, and then we have two the second and third and fourth, and finally on Christmas Eve we light all. Why do we do that? We do that because the light is coming into the world. And as the Gospel of John tells us, the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness cannot overcome it. We needed light. Because we were too in love with the darkness. Sin is easy, and it was easier to give into it time and time again. It became natural, right? Anybody who thinks it's hard to sin hasn't been trying. I don't know. Comes real easy, doesn't it? Just a stray thought. Ooh, oh, that one person. A little bit of bitterness. Just a little white lie. Maybe I don't like that person because of how they talk or how they look. Lots of little sins slip in. And we couldn't stop, no matter how hard we tried. But God in His mercy saw fit not to leave us in the darkness, but instead to bring the light to us. To bring hope to us. To bring salvation to us. When we could not get to God, He came to us. And the light that was Christ came in a tiny baby. In an average town, in the back of an inn, in a stable with animals. I think there's enough of us in this town that know how great it smells when you're amongst a bunch of animals, right? Not necessarily the ideal conditions for the arrival of the light of the entire world. And yet, He came anyway. Because He came to take on our brokenness, our flesh, our blood. Not as a king up in a castle somewhere on a hill staring down at us. But one of us down in the dirt and the stink and the muck and the mire of life itself, where the darkness was. The light had to come here among us. Some of y'all probably left lights on in your house. Maybe you got Christmas lights on somewhere. Anybody got Christmas lights up? They don't help us much right here, do they? All the way off there, wherever they are. As we're gathering here tonight, we needed light right here. Lights up here. Lights back here. Could have really used the light right there. We needed the light here with us. And that's what Jesus came to be. There's a lot of darkness still in our world today. This world does not favor the light. This world likes the darkness. It's easier to be sneaky in the darkness, to get your way, to do what you want. But light has come that we might overcome, that we might be set free from darkness. And that light is Jesus. I invite you tonight. If you're tired of the darkness, invite the light in. You ever try to navigate your home in the middle of the night in the dark? It's hard. Much like walking through this life, we stub our toes on this or that. We trip over one thing and we bang into another. We need the light. We're here tonight because the light came to us. And I invite you. First of all, if you don't know Jesus as your Savior, tonight's your night. Tonight is your opportunity to accept Him as your Lord and Savior. And we'll pray in a little bit, and I invite you to pray with me if you haven't accepted Him yet. But as well, if you're already in Christ, I suspect most of you are, if not all of you, I want you to invite that light deeper into your life. Because here's the thing, we're all ready to be done with 2020, right?
Yeah.
But the darkness is still going to be there in 2021. I hate to tell you that. Unless we are willing to carry that light out into this world. Because you see, when you are in Christ, that light is in you. And you have a choice. You can let the darkness win. You can give in to the temptation, to the despair, to the hopelessness that this world constantly throws at us. I suspect that all of these post-apocalyptic movies and books and television shows that we see, what life is like after some major disaster or another. I suspect we're so obsessed with that right now because we are so deep in despair, we can't see hope for the future. 40 years ago, we looked ahead to 2020 and we saw flying cars and floating cities. We saw humanity united and happy and robots doing our dishes. And we got here as it was just as dark as it was in 1980. Just as dark as it was in 1960 or any other year. But Jesus says, you are the light of the world. if he is in you. A city on a hill cannot be hidden. So be that light this year. Rise above the despair of this culture that is caught in endless wars between one thing and another, between this and that, this party and that party, this belief and that belief, this color and that color, and point people to a deeper hope in Christ our Savior. They need it, guys. They need the hope. Our world is in darkness. Let Christ be the light in you. Let us pray. Almighty God, shine in us. Lord, come into our hearts this night. If you don't have Christ as your Savior, I invite you to pray with me now. Lord Jesus, come into my heart. I repent of my sins. Forgive me for the things that I have done in rebellion against you, where I have loved darkness more than the light, where I have embraced temptation rather than run from it. Forgive me. Lord, I turn my back on that life and turn towards you. I confess that you are Lord. I believe that God raised you from the dead, that you died for my sins and rose again to be my salvation and my Savior, and I accept you into my heart this day. Be my Savior, Father, Lord Jesus. Be my Savior. Set me free. Send your Holy Spirit down upon me that I might live in you, and that your light might shine through me in Jesus' name. Now all of you pray with me. Father God, be the light in us. This world loves the darkness, and too often we have loved the darkness with it. Forgive us where we have embraced despair and hopelessness, where we have embraced apathy and indifference, where we have trudged ahead into the darkness rather than shining as the light. Set us upon a stand. Let us be a city on a hill, shining bright into the darkness with a light that the darkness cannot overcome. Shine in us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The ushers are going to bring around some glow sticks. And as we sing together Silent Night, as we remember the coming of our Savior on a quiet night, let us begin to light up Barron Park and take it out to LaBelle and to the world. You know, the legend of Silent Night is that it was a part of a kind of a weird Christmas in and of itself. The church organ had broken, and they weren't going to have anything to sing Christmas carols with that year. And somebody decided to write a song about a silent night. A holy night, where all was calm and yet all was bright, because around a virgin mother and child, holy infant so tender and mild, who was sleeping in heavenly peace, the child that was the light of the world. Let us stand and shine our light as we sing together. Thank you.
sing with us silently.
Take this light with you. But even more importantly, take the light of Christ with you into this world. Shine it for all to see. Do not let the darkness overcome. Let light radiate from you, that all may know the way of salvation. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, go in peace, and Merry Christmas.